Needs no introduction in this group or in this city, Mr. Vincent McGowan. The most important thing you need to know about Vince is that he is a Marine. So it's no surprise to me that he has approached life, both uniform and out, with tenacity. Vince served with the Marine Combined Action Platoon in Vietnam, embedded among villagers in the countryside. Through great personal risk, Sergeant Mack, as he was known then, and his Marines not only protected their village, but in doing so helped develop many of the principles and tactics we use in counterinsurgency today. Upon return to civilian life, Vince displayed the same resolve, the same creativity and commitment in serving his community and his fellow veterans. And as many of you know, he founded the United War Veterans Council, which has made today's commemoration possible. So we literally would not be here without you, and I'd ask him to come on up. We have a special presentation for Mr. Vince. In recognition of his lifetime of service, it is my honor to present Vince with a very special paddle, which was handcrafted by a combat wounded force reconnaissance team leader. We also know Adam Levine, sir, from one Marine to another. Thank you and Semper Fidelis.
Yeah, yeah. Well, to say I'm overwhelmed is a bit of an understatement, but thank you, sir. Thank you, Commandant. Thank you, Adam, for this. Look at this thing. I'll be paddling my kayak out around Long Island Sound faster than ever now. Just recall that the veterans community really stands for solidarity. Regardless of the things that separate Americans, service to our country, honor amongst our relationships with one another, trust and respect of one another, have been the hallmark of every successful veteran organization and has been the platform on which we built the United War Veterans Council. Going forward after 100 years with the new men and women who I see filling in the ranks of our aging veterans, it's heartfelt to understand that the legacy will continue. We're honored to have the Commander-in-Chief here for the first time. I think with the reception that he's gotten here, it will not be the last time that we have a Commander-in-Chief. Remember, every year is a different service year. We have been blessed to have the Marine Corps here this year with the Commandant, having all the pomp and ceremony at our disposal. Thank you very much, sir. And to all our supporters and to all of our Grand Marshals, and particularly our Gold Star families and the loved ones of the Marines that survived, the spouses and the parents and the siblings of service members who put up with us and give us care and succor as we need it as we come off our service and grow older. Thank you all very much. Thank you, Bruce Mosler, for all that you do for the veterans community in New York City. It's an honor to have and a privilege to have been able to say Semper Fidelis to New York. Mr. Mayor, thank you, sir, for all that you've done for building the veterans community in New York City. We recall your father's service and how he suffered, and you look at the outcome. His suffering bore a son like you who ends up leading the Fifth Avenue Parade. So thank you very much. Thank you very much, New York. See you again next year. Number five.